Hello friends, welcome to Income Tax School. Today we'll be learning about the slab rate. Okay, so today you will learn what rate of tax are you paying to the government, under which tax rate do you fall. So in this budget 2020, there's two type of schemes. One is existing schemes and other is new scheme. Under existing scheme, there are three rates: 5%, 20%, and 30%. Under the new scheme, there are six rates: 5%, 10%, 15%, 20%, 25%, and 30%. Okay. If you are opting for existing scheme, you can get income tax deductions of rupees 1.5 lakhs under 80C. So under existing scheme, you have 80C deductions. You can avail 80C deduction. But under new scheme, you will not get 80C reductions. Okay. So if you have invest in FD, fixed deposit, or if you are incurring tuition fees for your children, and if you have NPS, okay, national certificates, if you have NSC certificate, national saving certificate, okay, or if you have invested, if you've taken loan and you are paying the principal and interest amount, if you have invested in any of the 80C reduction, you can avail reduction up to rupees 1.5 lakh. Or if you have taken fixed deposit, or if you have invested the amount in PF, public fund, PF or PPF, public provident fund, you can offer existing scheme. If you have not made any investment, you should offer new scheme. So let us see in which rate do you fall, which slab rate do you fall. So here's the table. Now in case your yearly income is up to rupees 2,50,000, you don't have to pay tax. There's nil tax. So if your income is up to rupees 2,50,000, you don't have to pay tax, neither in the existing scheme nor in the new scheme. Now if your income is between 250 to 5 lakhs, suppose your income is 3 lakhs, okay, you have to pay 5% tax on the difference between your income and the lowest slab rate. So in this case, your income is 3 lakhs, you have to pay tax on 3 lakhs minus 2,50,000, because up to 2,50,000 there is no tax. The difference is 50,000. On 50,000 you have to pay your tax. Okay. Suppose your income is 5 lakhs. The difference between 5 lakhs and 250 lakhs is 250 lakhs. So you have to pay tax 5% on 2.5 lakhs. Okay. Now if your income falls between 5 to 7,50,000, you have to pay 20% rate of tax. Okay. Under existing scheme. Under new scheme, it is 10% rate of tax. Okay. If your income is between 750 to 10 lakhs, under existing scheme it is same as 20%, but under new scheme it is 15%. Okay. If your income is between 10 lakh to 12,50,000, so above 10 lakh under existing scheme it is 30%, and below 10 lakh it is 20%. In case of new scheme, above 10 lakh to 12,50,000, it is 20%. And if your income is between 12,50,000 to 15 lakh, under the existing scheme is 30%, and the new scheme it is 25%. Above 15 lakh, in the both case, it is 30%. So now let us see what is your income is. Go and check your pay slip. Okay. And find out your total income. If your total income is 10 lakh, you are under 20% slab rate in case of existing scheme, and if you are opting for new scheme, it is 15%. But in new scheme, you cannot take 80C deductions. Okay. Apart from these tax, this slab rate, there's some more taxes you have to pay to government. Okay, let's see that. See, we have the surcharge, which is tax on tax. Suppose you are paying to the government 1 lakh tax, Okay, assume it we are paying 1 lakh, and your income exceed 50 lakhs rupees. Okay, so you have to pay 10% on 1 lakh. It is tax on tax. Okay, suppose your income exceed 1 crore, and suppose you are paying to the government around 10 lakhs, you're paying 10 lakh tax to the government. So apart from tax, you have to pay surcharge also, which is tax on tax. Okay, so it will be 15% of 10 lakhs. In the same case, if your income is 2 crore, it will be 25%. If you exceed 5 crore, it will be 37%. So check it out. If your income is more than 50 lakhs, you have to pay surcharge also. If it's less than 50 lakhs, you don't have to worry. You don't have to pay any surcharge. Okay. So surcharge is paid when income is exceed 5 lakhs, 50 lakhs. Okay. And there's 4 rate: 10%, 15%, 25%, and 37%. Okay. So you need not worry if your income is less than 50 lakhs. You don't have to pay tax. Now, after surcharge, after slab rate and surcharge, there's one more tax. This is education cess. Education cess, you have to pay on your income tax. Suppose, taking the same example, if your income tax after calculating from the slab rate is 1 lakh, you have to pay 4% of income tax as an education cess, which will go to the government for the secondary and higher secondary education. Okay. If you are paying surcharge also, so income tax plus surcharge, on income tax and surcharge you have to pay 4% tax. So the activity for you today is go and find out how much tax are you paying, okay, and what is your slab rate. Are you falling under 5% or 20% or 30%, or under new scheme are you falling under 5%, 10%, 15%, 20, 25, 30? Are you also paying surcharge if your income is greater than 50 lakhs? Okay, and rate differs as your income increases. Okay, education says you have to pay whether your income is above 50 lakhs or not. In every case, you have to pay the education tax if you are paying the taxes. So if you are paying the taxes, you have to pay the education cess. Okay. So the today activity is find out your rate. Which rate of tax are you paying? And which slab rate are you in? Okay. Thank you.